We want to find a possible equation for a quadratic function that has zeros, -1/3, and +2/5. Remember, the zeros of a quadratic function give us information about the factors of the quadratic function. So for a quick review, the zeros or roots are the x values that make the function equal to zero. So if the zeros or roots are r(1) and r(2), then a possible quadratic function would be f of x equals any constant a times a factor of x minus r(1) times a factor of x minus r(2). Again, where r(1) and r(2) are the zeros. And we can also check our answer graphically if the given zeros are real. If we graph the function, the x-intercepts will be the zeros of the function. Again, as long as the zeros are real. So going back to our example, if the first zero is -1/3, our function must contain a factor of x minus -1/3. And if the second zero is 2/5, the function must also contain a factor of x minus 2/5. Let's go ahead and simplify this first factor. This would be the same as x plus 1/3. Remember, subtracting a negative is the same as adding a positive. The second factor would be still x minus 2/5. Now we could multiply this out in this form, but notice how we'd have to work with fractions and we'd have fractional coefficients. We can avoid this by remembering we can multiply this function by any constant and it would still have the same zeros. Notice how this constant has a denominator of 3. If we multiplied this first factor by 3, it would eliminate the fraction in this factor. Notice the second factor has a denominator of 5. If we multiplied the second factor by 5, it would eliminate the denominator in the second factor. And since 3 times 5 is equal to 15, this would be the same as multiplying our two factors here by a constant of 15. So now we'll distribute the 3 here and here, and the 5 here and here. So we'll have f of x equals, this would be 3x plus 1. The second factor would be 5x and then minus 2. Now we'll multiply these two binomials to find our possible quadratic function. Remember, here we'll have four products, 1, 2, 3, and 4. So we'll have f of x equals 15x squared minus 6x plus 5x minus 2. Last step, we'll combine our like terms. Notice how we have two x terms. So our function f of x is equal to 15x squared. This would be minus 1x, or just minus x, minus 2. So when given zeros that are fractions, it's more common to clear the fractions from the binomial factors before we multiply and determine a possible quadratic function. And for the last step, we can go ahead and graph this function to make sure it does cross the x-axis at these two values of x. Here's a graph of our function. Notice how the x-intercept here looks like it is -1/3, and the x-intercept here does look like it's about +2/5. Okay, I hope you found this helpful.